May I record you for a class at Rutgers University, Modern Middle East?
Yes, you may.
Okay. I have a couple questions for you. The first one is, how are Muslim women or Middle Eastern women of color or even just women in general represented in the media, commercials, art, or literature?
Middle Eastern women?
Yeah.
They're dressed modestly, with head coverings, like hijabs and burqas and all that stuff. No different than any other religious woman in any other religious... Like, if they're either, like, modern, like, they're secular or religious. The religious ones are, like, any other religious woman in most religious sects. They're dressed modestly, and then the secular ones dress like Americans.
Okay. Do you think that, certain times they're represented as, needing the help of people outside their communities?
I'd say that Muslim women in the Western world do not need help, but women in countries like Saudi Arabia and like where women don't have the right to drive, or in countries where female circumcision is practiced, I'd consider them, yeah, they do need help.
Is Islamic Muslim feminism an oxymoron?
No, no. That's a stupid question. No, that's not an oxymoron.
Okay. What kind of things do you think could be done to empower these women in general or specifically in the Middle East, like you were talking about before?
I think that there are elements of progress. I know that most major cities in the U.S. and like in the Western world, the women are starting to create their own mosques and stuff like that in prayer communities. However, I think that it's just things are changing, but these are 1,000-year-old traditions and cultures and stuff like that, and change doesn't happen overnight. And I think that people need to understand that change is happening, and by promoting ideas of religious freedom and toleration, that change will happen, and that women who do feel like they want to be religious and live a certain lifestyle will, and then women who don't will leave their communities and be part of the modern world.
When you think about the war in Iraq and stuff like that, do you think that any part of it had to do with helping out the women who can't, who are not living such easy lives? Do you think any part of it had to do with that?
No. No. Americans didn't like Saddam Hussein. Americans are a little bit racist, and Americans want to protect their oil interests. We can say that we helped some women out, but I'm sure that we didn't help out the women who lived in northern Iraq that were sold into slavery when they were when that area was conquered by ISIS. No.
And last question.
The gay community is worse in Iraq now than it was before Saddam Hussein. Like, all the ethnic minorities, that's a lie. Like, we didn't help anybody out.
Okay. And then last question is, do you know any famous or influential Muslim women? You can take a minute to think. If you don't know any, that's fine.
I'd say no, but I also want to make it clear that I don't really know that many famous or influential Muslim men, and I don't really actively engage myself in the Muslim community. Besides, the King of Saudi Arabia that I know who's a Muslim, I don't really care. And I'd also say that it's not about the role of women that this question should be targeting. It should really be, I'm not educated on the Muslim community as a whole, and the 1 billion or so Muslims that live in the world. The leaders, I know, Sisi, and I know, the dictators of the countries, but we also have to recognize that the leaders of the Western world, they're also mostly men, except for, Merkel.
Thank you.